Her 22-year-old sister, Margaret, was having an affair with a divorced royal servant. Now, previous...
Margaret! Peter, stop her for me!
What?
No!
I've got her, Elizabeth!
Throw her in! Go on! I've no way to treat a princess!
One! Two!
Your Majesty.
Papa! Save me!
While King George was alive, there were two princesses, Elizabeth and Margaret. But the happy days of the royal family weren't destined to last.
We've got to be strong. For Mummy. For Papa.
I've been waiting for you.
I'm sorry.
Your Majesty.
Now, up you get. Oh, you look so tired.
We listened to your tour on the wireless. Papa was so proud.
And of you.
He was out all day shooting. Making jokes over dinner. I thought he was getting better.
You have to rest. And I must go and see Tommy. Shall I send for the doctor? I'll give you something to calm you.
Why are you going?
So much to do. I'm sorry, I'll come to you later.
Naturally, they were both very, very sad. But I think maybe Princess Margaret, she had another reason to be sad. She said, well...
And Lord, help the sister who comes between me and my man.
In the months after the king's death, the differences between the two sisters grew ever wider.
It falls to me, a sovereign.
Well, be buffalo.
Margaret, left alone at the palace, was kept company by a Battle of Britain war hero, who had been employed by the king as an equerry to help him organise his diary. His name was Group Captain Peter Townsend. Now she was 21 and he was 37. He had been an escort to both of the princesses for many years, but now there was only one of them to look after.
Members of the household.
Who are now my people.
Margaret, I can't say thanks.
Shh! Papa used to take us down here during the war. Training for air raids. You're probably flying overhead. Protecting the realm. I was just a little girl.
Margaret, this is madness.
But I'm grown up now.
But I want to ask you all. Whatever your religion may be, to pray for me on that day.
Don't stop.
May God bless and guide you all.
Now we must catch up.
All right.
We're out of sight.
No, not now.
Why not?
Now we must keep walking.
Oh, must we?
No.
What's the matter?
I'm filing for divorce.
Oh.
Rosemary's taken up with someone else. It's my fault, apparently. Spent too much time with you. Your family.
Poor Peter.
Peter Townsend had been involved...
Excuse me. Going off somewhere at this hour. Just another party. You don't have to go, surely. Well, it'll be fun. Of course it will. If anyone escapes, you'll have to get married. You'll know when the right one comes along.
Perhaps he has. I've been seeing rather a lot of Peter.
Come with me. Peter. Peter's a kind, wonderful man. You know he is.
He is, but he's married.
He's getting divorced.
Margaret.
He's the innocent party. I thought you'd be happy for me.
Margaret.
He's asked me to marry him. I told him yes.
A man about a boy.
But Margaret wasn't afraid of the disapproval of the palace establishment, and the concerns of her sister did nothing to turn her away from her affair with Peter Townsend.
I'm so ashamed of it, but must admit the sleepless nights I've had about the boy.
Fairy stories tell us that we must have around. And that aspect was very much in the air, that she was a scarlet woman. And that must have been extremely difficult for the Queen to have entertained.
I'm feeling quite insane and young again, and all because I'm mad about the...
Fond of Peter, you know. Anyways, he's part of the family.
It was never meant for it to happen like this.
No. I do so want you to be happy, Margaret.
Peter makes me happy. If only...
My coronation is 2 months away. Will you do something for me? Will you promise me something?
Of course.
Will you wait? Do nothing, say nothing. Keep this relationship secret. Will you give me your promise?
For how long?
Until after my tour of the Commonwealth.
That's a year away.
I parted more than a year before consenting to my marriage.
And after your tour? What then?
Then, if you feel the same, we'll do all we can.
We won't breathe a word. I promise. Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Everything. When Margaret reached forward to brush it off Peter Townsend's lapel, the world's press knew instantly what this intimate gesture really meant.
Margaret.
Tommy's just told me. He says you agreed it.
Margaret, sit down.
Banishing him.
Posting him.
And I'm not allowed to visit?
The press speculation has been so intense.
You can't do this. Please, Lilibet.
Margaret, I'm sorry. The newspapers will not leave us in peace so long as Peter remains. We have no choice. If you try and fight this, you will make matters worse.
Lilibet, when I get back from Rhodesia, will Peter still be here?
I don't know.
Please. To say goodbye.
Of course he will.
Their absence fanned them. A year after going to Brussels, Townsend flew back for a secret meeting using a false name to avoid the press. If they wanted to stop them now, the palace would have to find a new form of attack. It was time for Tommy's
relationship. I think that must have been an excuse for her unhappiness.
According to Lascelles, Margaret would have to give up her right to the succession, her title, and her royal income.
Both be free. You'll be free of the decision, and I'll be free to make it. There's nothing more you need to know.
Don't worry. Tommy did spell it out for me. Said I'd lose everything if I married Peter.
be Mrs. Townsend living in a rented flat. Doing my own washing. Cooking Peter's bloody supper. But I'll not be told what to do by him. In fact, I've written to the Prime Minister. Sir Anthony seems a good sort. For a married divorcee. I want to keep him abreast of what has happened. So that if the time comes, he will not be against us. What will you say? That I'm going to wait till October. When Peter's in London. I've been missing him so much, Lilibet, you can't imagine. I just need to see him one more time. To be totally sure.
If Margaret married, all she would have to give up would be the slim prospect of becoming queen herself. But all the other barriers were taken away. Nothing need stop her now. The queen avoided her.
Is the queen still out walking?
Yes, ma'am.
Without speaking to her sister, Margaret left for London. And the long-awaited reunion with Peter.
Nothing to say, nothing to say. I swear I'm saying it in my sleep. They're supposed to be on our side. Can you believe this? Queen's press secretary announces that no announcement is at present contemplated. A no-announcement, only from the palace.
Peter, shut up! Sorry.
No. No, I'm sorry.
The palace called.
You've spoken to the Queen.
They want me to go to Windsor at the weekend. On my own.
Should we take some air, Margaret?
Of course.
If that is what you would like.
The world's gone mad. I've been so frightened.
Well, you're safe here. No photographers. Poor thing, you've been besieged.
I've wanted to see you. To talk to you for so long.
You've got so many friends. Newspaper editors. Even the Prime Minister.
I feel so alone.
What about Peter?
Peter's been... very supportive.
It is what you want, isn't it, Margaret? You can have it now.
Isn't it enough to want to be happy?
Do you really think we are so free to put our own happiness first? People look to us, Margaret, to our family. To reflect what is noble in themselves. And what matters most? Is it how we dress? Where we live? Or is it how we behave?
Lilibet!
You may keep the appearance of royalty, Margaret. But if you do this, will the substance of who we are, who you really are, ever be the same?
I never wanted to go against your wishes, Lilibet. I never wanted to defy you.
You never have. But this is not my decision now. It is yours.
I wanted to say goodbye before you go to Africa.
We hardly see you now. I suppose I'm kept busy. I read about you. Parties, openings. Are you enjoying society life?
I try not to be alone too much.
Papa would be so proud of you.
Would he?
Of course.
I think about Papa a great deal, and I wonder if you would...
Margaret, I have to go. I'll write to you very soon. Goodbye.